To streak a plate, you'll need the bacterial cells you're plating, a fresh agar plate, and something to spread with. Perhaps a sterile toothpick, pipette tip, or wire loop. If you're using a wire loop, you'll also need a Bunsen burner. Start by gently touching your stock cells with the toothpick. Just a soft touch is enough to get all the cells you'll need. Carefully, using a back and forth zigzag motion, spread the cells across one side of the agar. Don't apply too much pressure, or you'll damage the agar. This first area will form a thicker lawn of cells. To produce individual colonies, grab a fresh, sterile toothpick and drag it through the area you just spread cells over. Use that same zigzag motion to spread them out even more. But wait, we're not done yet. Grab one last sterile toothpick and repeat the same motion. Drag it through the second area and spread the cells in a zigzag motion. This third area will give you the best chance at isolating single colonies. If you're using a wire loop, the process will be exactly the same, except you need to sterilize the loop in between streaks. Hold the wire loop in the flame of the burner for 2 to 3 seconds, then be sure to let it cool before touching the cells. Place your plate in the correct incubator. Tomorrow, you'll be able to see single colonies. This video is brought to you by JM109 Competent Cells, a competent case strain you can rely on.